So today we are going to learn divisibility. Are you ready to learn? Let us start. Many a time we do need to find whether a number is divisible by any other number. At that time, if it is given any one number to you, how can you find out whether that number is divisible by which number? Is there any shortcut for that? Yes, divisibility rule will help you. At the end of this video, you are going to learn divisibility rules for different numbers. By looking at the numbers, you can just understand which number can be divided by this number. So, let us start learning. Yes. Divisibility rules. Now, what is divisibility mean? It means that after dividing, there will be no remainder. You can see you can do division by any method. You can see here 6 is divided by 3, but there is no remainder. You can write in any way 6 division 3. That is also you can see 6, 3, 2s are 6. So that is there is no remainder. So when you are dividing any number by another number, when there is no remainder, then that is called it is divisible by that number. Can you tell me by just looking at these numbers, they are divisible by which number? Are they divisible by 2, by 3, by 4, by 5, or by 6? You are going on thinking which number I will take to divide these numbers. It can be 2 digit, it can be huge number also. If then there are numbers are given to us to divide, we will think first, which number can I take to divide this number? How can I simplify this number? So you are going on thinking whether shall I divide by this number, 6, 7, 8 or any other number. I will start dividing the number by just division method. I will tell you if I do like this, it will take me some time. After solving each trial, if the remainder is 0, then I will say this is divisible by that number. Instead of there, is there any other method? Yes, there is a trick where you can find easy way. Yes, there is a way to make it easy. The divisibility rules can help you. First, we'll start with 0. 0 is divisible by any number. And number 1, every number is divisible by 1. Now, what is divisible by means? Divisible by and can be exactly divided means the same thing. If you divide any number by other, the result is a whole number without a remainder. For example, 12 is divided by 6. When 12 is divided, there is no remainder. It is completely divisible by 6. 6 2s are 12. 15 divided by 5. 5 3s are 15. There is no remainder. So I can say, when there is no remainder, then that number is divisible by this number. I can say here 12 is divisible by 6. It is completely divisible by 6. 15 is divisible by 5. Let us move ahead. Divisibility by 2. If I ask you, is this number divisible by 2? How will you find out? Will you do the normal method? It will take a lot of time. So, let us see rule for 2. A number is divisible by 2 if it has any of these digits like 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8 in its ones place. Which is the ones place? Is the last digit. This is in ones place. Now, which number is there here in ones place? 8. Which is there in this list? 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8. Yes, here this number has got 8 in its units place, which is the last digit is 8. So I can say this number is completely divisible by 2. In this case, what we have to see, what only the last digit unit place we have to observe. How big that number is. But we are only observing last one digit. And if that digit is having 0, 2, 4, 6 or 8, that means that number is divisible by 2. Let us see some more examples. Just you need to see the unit place here. 0, 2, 4, 6. Here again 0, here 6, here 8, here 2, here 4. These all numbers you can see here, one of this digit of divisibility rule. So these all numbers are divisible by 2. Can you see all the unit place? Just see the unit place, last digit. This is 4, 8, 4, 2, 6. Yes, all these numbers are divisible by 2. Look at this example. Here last digit is 9, 3, 1, 5. That means these numbers are not divisible by 2. Let us move to next number, divisibility by 5. Can you tell me which this number is divisible by 5? Or you are going to divide it by 5? No. For this 2, we have divisibility rule. What it says? A number which has either 0 or 5 in its ones place, then it is divisible by 5. Now, what is this number have in its units place? 0. Yes, you have 0 or 5. So, you have 0. So, I can say this number is divisible by 5. Look at these numbers. All are divisible by 5 because they have either 0 or 5 in ones place. Look at more examples. Look at these examples. 10, 5, 5, 0, 5. Only look at the unit place. It is either 0 or 5. So all these numbers are divisible by 5. Observe these numbers. In these numbers, you can see these are 7, 3, 9, 6, 1. There is no 0 or 5 in the unit place. So I can say directly these numbers are not divisible by 5. Only you have to observe the last digit. Let us move to the next number. Divisibility by 10. Can you tell me this number is divisible by 10? Or will you divide? No. You are going to use divisibility test for 10. Let us see what does it say. If a number has 0 in the ones place, then it is divisible by 10. Look at this example. 7,630 ends in a 0. So it is divisible by 10. 410 ends in a 0. It is too divisible by 0. You can see here. 20, 130, 160, 5,860, all have units place is 0. Ones place is 0. You can see the last number is 0. So here you can say all these numbers are divisible by 10. Look at these examples. Only concentrate on unit place. 7, 3, 9, 6, 1. None of the examples are having last digit is 0. Or units place is 0. So these numbers are not divisible by 10. Let us see how much we have understood divisibility rule for 2, 5 and 10. Students, I hope now you have understood the concept why we are learning divisibility, and now I am sure you will be able to answer any number which is given to you, either divisible by 2, 5 or 10. Take out some different numbers and try out for divisibility by 2, 5 and 10. As I always say, maths requires practice. Do practice. All the best, students.